Welcome to another adventure with Getting Lost. Today we're doing a special video here for the Kallang Riverside Park, a park that we have visited previously. And in front of us now is the guest holder number 3 structure, which is actually the supporting pillars and girders for the guest holder number 3. And this is one of the structures that is a remembrance of the location here of what it used to be. And join me after the intro to find out more about this park. Welcome back, and today we are at the Kallang Riverside Park, which is a river park in Kallang, and it sits on the confluence of the Kallang River and the Rochor River at the north of the Kallang Basin. This park here is a 7-hectare park, which is popular for water sports, and also, there's a stretch of area where people like to come for picnics, and there are also like exercise equipment for fitness and also jogging tracks. But what's so interesting about this place is that there is a place here that not many people know about, and it's forgotten, and it's a secret place that if you walk around here, you can just walk past it without even noticing it's here. And like in all parks, there are lots of trees around here. And this secret place that we're going to, which is at the Kallang Riverside Park, where this site here used to be the site of the old gasworks in Singapore. And you can just walk past this secret place without even knowing it. And the secret place is... No, it's not this building here that you see here. It's definitely not this building, but it's nearby here. It's actually this grove of trees. Yes, as you see this grove of trees here, these are I think an angsana tree, and you can see the trees here is unique, and these trees go all along Southeast Asia, and the trees are very unique in that the roots actually grow down from their bark and creates a very thick area underneath the trees, a very thick growth of lots of roots. And inside the roots here, if you can look at it, it's actually a structure, a small little house, a small little hut, a small little place inside this tree, under this tree. And this place here has been abandoned for a long, long time, and now nobody even knows what this place used to be. There are certain, people did try to support this structure by putting like wooden beams, you know, and also metal beams to actually support the walls of the structure here. But as you can see, all the branches, all the roots have overgrown this whole structure everywhere. And now this place here mostly is almost falling apart. Without the trees, without the roots, it would just fall down. So the roots now are actually supporting more of the wall. And if you can see here, you can also tell that part of the wall has actually fallen over, and this place here most likely does not have a roof. And the only roof here, as you go in here, you can see the wall is gone. And you see there's actually a metal pipe here, probably a water pipe. And on top here, no roof. The only roof you have is the canopy of leaves on top. And this place here is abandoned, and nobody knows what it is. What could it have been? It could have been a house. Somebody stayed here, but it's very small. Nobody knows. But what you can see here is around the tree, you see a lot of idols, a lot of deities being put here. And one of the reasons is because this type of trees, people believe that spirits live in this type of trees. So because of that, sometimes if the tree grows very big, a lot of people wouldn't dare to cut down the tree, or they like this place here, they put in idols here and they make offerings to the spirits living in the tree. And there are even stories about how a big tree like this will be at the construction site, and when people try to cut down the tree, they fall sick or they go crazy and somehow the tree wasn't cut down. So there are many stories about this type of trees in actually mostly by word of mouth in these Asian countries here, especially like Southeast Asian countries, where in the past a lot of people believe in spiritualism or spirits that live in trees, you know, all those occult, all those supernatural things that came before modernization. Anyway, that was the secret of the Kallang Riverside Park, a place that, like I said, nobody knows about. If you tell people about this place, they wouldn't believe you. And this is the place, like I said, you could just walk past here every day and you would not even notice that it's there. But what we're going to do now is we're going to continue walking along here. The river beside me now is actually the Rocho River, and people can actually cross over the river using this bridge to head towards Golden Mile Complex, North Bridge Road. And if you keep heading down this direction, you will come to a wall, or where there used to be a wall, where the Kallang Gasworks used to be. And like I said in an earlier video, in the past, people didn't like to come to this area because when you come to this area here, there was the smell of gas in the air, and people were afraid that the gasworks would catch fire. So in the past, not many people like to come into this area here, but the gaswork has mostly been demolished, except for a little bit of a reminder that we saw at the beginning of the video. And now the land where the gaswork sat at for more than 137 years, it's barren. It's just a flat land with just a big field. And some people even say that the land there may be contaminated because the gaswork was there for more than 137 years. So they, when you do refining of coal and refining of gas, there are a lot of pollutants and waste products that are produced from that. And so a lot of people believe that some of those pollutants actually has been leached into the land. So the government, after they demolished the place, they left it empty for a very, very long period of time. And until only now, where they have started to try to maybe recover the place. And what they seem to be doing now, as you can see on my right here, they actually fenced off the place and they are actually doing some work at the site. So I would think that they will probably be trying to convert it into a park, which I would think that would be the better solution instead of building any residential places here. But that is for the government to decide. What I'm thinking of now is, boy, is it hot. As we keep walking along the side of the Rocho River, this part here is still part of the Kallang Riverside Park. So in the past, the Kallang Gasworks was a very important location because it helped, first of all, when it first started, to provide gas for the street lamps for the whole island, and then after that, for the whole city. And after that, they started to produce kerosene or gas for people to do home cooking at home. So because of that, it actually helped to with the economic development of Singapore. And here, if you keep walking here, you'll finally reach to the road. And the road here, there's actually a bridge crossing the road. And this bridge here is called Crawford Bridge. And the road that's going across the bridge is also called Crawford Road, where the bridge gets its name from. And so in the past, this bridge here was an important bridge, but nowadays, not many people even know the name of the bridge. But if you keep heading further up, you'll be heading along Rocho River, which we will not do much of in this adventure. But what we're going to do instead is we're going to end our adventure here today at the Rocho River, or this is only first part of the adventure here, but we're going to maybe not do a second part anytime soon. Maybe towards later in the year, I will continue our adventure here along the Rocho River, and we will see what we can find along the river here. So I guess that's it for now. I hope you enjoyed the secret location here at the Kallang Riverside Park that not many people know of. And thank you very much for joining me for this special adventure. I hope you enjoyed it. I surely did. And before we go, can you do me a favor? Please help me by liking my video, by clicking the thumbs up button, sharing my video, and also subscribing to my channel by clicking the subscribe button and also the bell icon so that you can get the latest notification about my videos. And lastly, but the most important thing, the thing that you have to do is to join me for my next adventure. I will see you there. Bye bye.